Hello everyone, it's Sarah from Spicy Pinecone, and today I am making Aleppo soap. I guess you could call it Aleppo inspired soap because unless you live in Syria and make your soap in giant vats the way that they do, it's going to be inspired by what they do. If you haven't seen the Aleppo soap making process, it is absolutely insane. I mean, they make it in these giant vats under the ground, and they cook it and they pour it out on the floor, and they use these giant rakes, and they have a man standing on the rake as they're cutting the soap. I'm going to put a link to the video that I watched in the video description below, because if you haven't seen it, it's something that it's really, really interesting, and I think that you should see it. I think you guys will get a kick out of it. So traditionally, when you're making Aleppo soap, you use olive oil and laurel berry oil. And the laurel berry can be anywhere from 2 to 40% is what I've seen. I kept mine at 25 with 75% olive oil. And I'm not going to put the lye and water because just the percentages, if you run it through a soap calculator, you'll be able to figure out the recipe very easily. Okay, so you can see how dark this is. And when Aleppo soap is made, it's typically a kind of a dark green color, and it matures out to a khaki. And Aleppo soap needs to cure for, I've heard people curing it for 6 months, but the longer you leave it, the better. And this is super dark, and the laurel berry oil has a very distinct smell. It's very kind of earthy and almost reminiscent of neem oil, but you can see how dark the laurel berry oil is. That is super dark, and this is way thicker than I expected it to be. When I poured it out, it was super, super thick. So I just blended it up with, you can hear my phone, someone's pinging me, but I blended it up with my olive oil, and it's this really, really deep green color. So I'm curious to see how this will turn out. Okay, now my lye is nice and cool. So we're gonna see if this is going to play nice or not. Got my mold ready. Okay, well that was not so bad at all. I'm going to pour it into my mold here. And this smell, I wish that you guys can smell it. It smells really different. But I like it. I didn't know what I would think about that, and I actually think it smells really, really good. Okay, gonna wait for it to firm up a little bit and texture the top. Okay, so I tried the top, and it's not quite where I want it to be. I want it to be just a little bit thicker. So I'm gonna let it sit for a little bit longer. I managed to run out and get the kids. Now this is the perfect texture. So that is the Aleppo soap, and it's going to sit for a day or two, and then I'm going to slice it with a log splitter and then set it up to cure for at the very least 6 months, but preferably 9 or more. And yeah, I'm looking forward to trying it. Okay, so this is my log splitter, and this is a custom log splitter that I had made by Bud. This is my third cutter that I purchased from him, and it has a string that runs along the side, up through here, comes across, and down over here. This will cut my soap blocks into whatever width I have the spacer set at, and you can adjust the tension of the string. There's a little doodad right there. You twist it to either loosen it or tighten it, and there is a cleat underneath the log splitter where you can hook it onto the table, so as you're pushing the block through, it won't slip. Okay, so I have my block and it's turned sideways and my string is nice and tight, and all you do is push it through. Now here is my first little log, and this can now be placed on my bar cutter and sliced into bars. Okay, so here I have my bar cutter, and what I'm going to do is take my logs, and since these are cut to be tall and skinny, I turn it sideways and line it up. Okay, now a question that I've been getting a lot is, why does Aleppo soap have to sit for so long? Why does it have to cure for so long? Aleppo soap cures for a minimum of 6 months, and the longer it sits, the better, because it is a high olive oil content soap. Now, soaps like Castile's, because they have so much olive oil in them, they have to sit for longer to allow the water to evaporate and the bar to harden. Also, olive oil isn't it doesn't create the best lather, but the longer it sits, the creamier and more bubbly the lather gets. So you let Aleppo soap sit for a minimum of 6 months to get the bar nice and hard and also allow the lather to be desirable instead of slimy.